Hey, what's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today I want to show you a mind mapping software. This is really useful when you want to show something that you're thinking in a visual way. Now, it's going to help you organize and structurize everything that you need to do for different use cases. And just to give you an example, let's just say that you're thinking about and creating a brand new software app, a new SaaS, right? And you want to have a developer make it. Well, you can talk to him and you can let him know what you're thinking, but he's not going to understand 100%. And if you don't get the message right, he will charge you extra for every single thing that you need. So this way, if you have it in a mind mapping software where it actually shows you everything that you have to do and what it needs to do, then he's going to know exactly what he has to develop. And it's going to save you time, money, and headaches. And like I said, there's a bunch of use cases. So the app that I'm talking about is called MindMaster. And what I'm going to do right now is jump over to the dashboard and show you what it's all about. All right, this is MindMaster, and it's made from Wondershare. These guys have years of experience, and one of the cool features about this, let me show you, it's available for Windows, Mac, Linux, and mobile. So you got Android, iPhone, and iPad. So basically, you can use it anywhere, and if you remember of an idea and you got something, just grab your phone and update it right there. So it's pretty cool that you have that option. So right now, I have it installed on my Mac, and there's available the blank templates that we can use. So you got the radial map, right map, the tree map, organized chart map, the fishbone one, which I've never heard about, but it's there, fishbone left, horizontal timeline, so on and so forth. Now you're gonna see that some of these say pro. Well, you can download the free version, you can check it out, you can use it, and if you need the pro version, well, you can buy it. And if you plan on buying it, please consider using the link in my description because it gives you a small commission and it won't cost you a single cent more. So you got more options available right here, and there's the templates. Templates are really awesome because they give you an idea of things that you need to think about, and sometimes you don't think about it. And like I said before, and I gave you that use case about creating and develop a brand new SaaS. For example, MindMaster made an introduction right here. Let me open it, and basically, let's just say, for example, you can tell a developer, hey, developer, I want a new SaaS and I want it to do this and that and blah, blah, blah. And I want to save and I want to have an export option, right? And you think that's all you have to explain. Well, you're wrong. You have to explain way more than that because he will only develop the basic things, and he won't develop the more complex things because you didn't tell him, right? So for example, what I'm talking about right now is right here. So for example, MindMaster, which is this one right here, knows that he has to create an import and export feature, right? And the export feature, which is this one right here, and it locks into this one. It's, for example, I need to export in graphics, right? And in graphics, we have the TIFF, BMP, GIF, PNG, and JPEG. If I wanted to export for MS Office, well, it's Word, PowerPoint, and Excel. And you're going into depth, more in-depth, and you're telling the developer what you actually need to have developed, right? Even the little simple things that you miss when you talk to him, well, it's right here when you mind map it. So it makes everything really clear. And trust me, it'll save you a ton of money with these guys because developers, if you miss something, they'll charge you extra for every single thing. So basically, it's really cool and it's really simple and easy to use. So for example, if I click on this feature right here, there's a little plus button right here that if I need to create another category, I just created a subtopic right here. And if I click on this one, I'll add another one. If I click again in the subtopic, it'll give me more subtopics right here. I can edit this by clicking on it, and I could say, for example, export again. And if I need to change the color on this one, we have the settings on the right. So for example, this little brush right here gives me the settings, for example, for the shape, for the image position, for the branch, and in this case, for the branch, if I hover over the color, it'll automatically show me what it's going to look like. So I'll just say this right here. If I wanted to change the line color right here, so for example, that's a really small line. Let me grab this one right here and change the line color for this one. Let me select it. Okay, the line color for this. See how the colors changes for that whole branch? Now this helps you out to visualize what you need to change in those. So for example, if I go like this, it'll grab the whole branch and it'll change the color. And a really cool feature that this has is that if I drag these, it'll lock into each other. For example, if I grab graphics and I go down, I have a visual way to see where it's going to lock in. So if I go there, it'll change the position. And it's cool because you're not kind of guessing, plus it's everything aligned, so you're not messing with that. Now we have more options here on the top. Let me go into home right here. We have obviously the basic ones like paste, cut, copy, format, painter. We got the topics right here, so we can create them from right here. Let me click on this one. All right, click on here. And if I could create a topic, I could create it from there, which is a topic. We got subtopics. Right now it selected that one, so it created a subtopic from there, another subtopic, a floating topic. I click here and it created a floating topic right there just in case I need it. And if I needed to drag in somewhere, for example, I'll drag that floating topic inside of there. So I can edit that and then have it inside of there. Multiple topics, if you need to create them right here with multiple. The relationship, so let's create another floating topic right here. Okay, and I'm gonna say relationship. Click on that and I get this little new arrow. So let's just say later on I decide that this fits in somewhere else. For example, on the main topic, I click on that and it'll align the little line there. So I know it has a relationship with that one there. There's callouts, a boundary, summary, mark, clip art, bunches. Oh, this one's really interesting one, the formula. I don't use it, but having it is really interesting to have formulas right here if you need to create those, which is pretty cool because it helps you create more complex things. And I'll show you what you can do that in the advance. You got hyperlinks, attachments, and so on and so forth right here. We got little icons available with this little star. These are really cool because, for example, you got priority, progress. Let's just say I grabbed this one right here, okay? I'm gonna click on this floating topic and I'm gonna say progress, right? And I'm gonna put that there, and we got that little icon right there. It's really cool because I click on it and it gives me all the little progress icons that have to do with that one. So for example, later on I can say, you know what, it's like 90% done. So I could do that. If I select numbers and then later on, if I click on that number, I get all the numbers icons there. So on and so forth with the arrows, the flags. It's cool because it saves you time. You don't need to delete it and grab another one. All right, next thing we have is the page style right here. This is a really interesting one because we can actually create, let me make this smaller right here. We can change the theme of this without actually editing the whole thing. Just by clicking on theme right here. Let's just say you like dark mode. Well, just select it, hover over it and see how it actually looks. Let's just say you don't like curved lines and you like straight lines. Well, select this theme right here. Let's cover that one. And it just changed the whole theme to that. We can create custom themes, theme fonts, theme colors, rainbows, hand draw, background colors, so on and so forth. This is really, really, really like extensive and complex if you need it. You can use the simple stuff, but it can become really complex when you actually need it. There's the slideshow if you need to create a slide preview, an auto create, auto slide, so on and so forth. There's the advanced option. This one is really interesting, the Gantt chart. The Gantt chart, if you are making a task mind mapping one, you have all the information right here like task, start, finish, duration, progress, priority. You can actually edit it right there and it'll update in the flow on the bottom. So that's super, super interesting. Next thing I want to show you is some of the templates right here. Now, maybe you're thinking, and I just gave you the idea of a developing of a SaaS, right? But there's so many things right here, like product marketing, main kind of plants, basic sentence patterns, health versus unhealthy. There's the little fish ones right here, academy availability. And this is really interesting right here because it tells you what you could do, like wedding day timeline. Like you wouldn't think about this using a mind mapping for it, but you could see it work, right? So you know what you have to do that day when you're gonna get married, right? So maybe this is out of topic, but it shows you that there's different stuff. There's a timeline for example, Einstein's timeline right here. So he's born this day, graduated, worked at Swiss Pan office, and you got a timeline right there. You can do that. Let's go see more. Let's see a basic one, a company structure. These are super common in every single company that wants to have a good structure and show their employees that there's actual structure and who is their boss, who is their like direct boss, and so on and so forth. Well, this helps you mind map that. So there's the office director, deputy, headquarters, and there's on the bottom, deputy director, they got the East Regional, South, West, and you got all that, these offices and those. And it gives you an idea. Now, I wanted to make this video because I know this could be really useful for many people And like I said before, if you are not using something like this, when you have a really good idea that you just can't explain by talking to someone, then you need something like this. Plus, this is really useful so you don't forget what you're thinking about. Right now, I'm working on an idea that I have for a SaaS, and I know it's super complex, and I know I can't talk to someone and let them know what it's going to do. I need to make something like this that shows them exactly what I need, and they have to do it this way because that's how it's gonna work. Because if they click on this, I need it to do that. And if it does this, then I need to open these options for them. And I need to have all that in the mind mapping software that I'm using right now. So basically that is MindMaster, and it's way more complex than what you're viewing right now, but it's pretty cool to have. Now, there's a great deal going on right now. I'm going to leave the link for two places where you could buy it. It's a different type of deal in each one, so check them out, and I will let you know in the description what I'm talking about. Well, like I said before, that link will be in the description. It's an affiliate link. It won't cost you a single cent more if you buy it from my link. It just helps me out with a small commission in case you guys want to support me. Well, that's it for today. My name is George. This is SaaS Master, and I'll see you guys later.